Let us consider this problem here. Notice that this is not a linear programming problem because x and y are constrained to be integers. Without these integrality conditions, what remains is a linear programming problem, and that's something that we know how to solve. Since there are only two variables, we could solve this problem graphically. Now the question is there an algebraic way of dealing with this? And the answer is yes. What we do is, we first ignore these integrality requirements on the variables. And what we are left with is just a linear programming problem. And this problem is called a linear programming relaxation of the original problem. And we'll just solve this first. Now, if we are lucky, we might end up with a solution such that x and y are both integers, and that will solve the problem. But we cannot always hope that that's the case. Anyway, we'll solve this linear programming relaxation and see what happens. And we'll do this graphically. Okay, so that's my feasible region. And it doesn't take too long to realize that if you solve this linear programming problem, we have a unique optimal solution right here. And this point is the intersection of the lines 2x plus y equal to 3 and x plus 3y equal to 5. That gives us the point 4 over 5 comma 7 over 5. As you can see, neither of these is an integer. Now we're going to look at the conditions x and y being integers. Clearly, if x is an integer, it cannot be 4 over 5. The integer values that are close to 4 over 5 are 0 and 1. What that means is, the points having x coordinate strictly between 0 and 1 are not feasible. Now we can use the fact that x is an integer to divide this problem into two. So we're going to look at the same problem divided into two cases. The first case is with x at most 0, and the second case x at least 1. Let me call these two problems P1 and P2 respectively. The reason is because there's no solution for the original problem that has x value strictly between 0 and 1, right? So they're either at most 0 or at least 1. And now, if we solve this problem P1, we will have an optimal solution right here, 0, 3. Whereas for the problem P2, we'll have an optimal solution here. So this point here is 1, 4/3. Now notice that 0, 3 is a feasible solution for the original problem because both are integers. And the objective function value of this solution is 3, right? 0 plus 3 is 3. And if we look at P2, x is now an integer, but y is not. And the integers that are close to 4 over 3 are 1 and 2. So we might apply the same idea again, and this time to the problem P2, and divide P2 into two subproblems. So one will have the additional constraint that says y is at most 1, and the other one is y is at least 2. And we solve again. Y is at most 1 is going to be this constraint here. And we see that an optimal solution will be here. And this point is going to be 2, 1. Whereas y greater than equal to 2 is this constraint here. And since we need x greater than or equal to 1, we'll have this constraint as well. And it's clear that an optimal solution for that problem is right here. And that point is 1, 2. Now, both solutions are integers. There's no need to explore further because 1, 2 is the best possible integer solution subject to all these constraints. And 2, 1 is the best possible integer solution subject to these constraints. And there's no other values for y that we need to consider. Now, let's take a look. So the objective function value for 0,3 is 3. But it turns out that all three solutions have the same objective function value. 2,1 and 1,2 also have objective function value equal to 3. And so, all three are optimal solutions for the original problem. The method that we have used to solve this problem is called branching. It is kind of like a divide and conquer method. Notice that we don't specify how we subdivide the problem in advance. We solve the original problem by ignoring the integrality constraints and use the solution to guide it into the subdivision process. In our case, we first look at the x value of our optimal solution for the linear programming relaxation. And we use that value to come up with the two constraints, x at most 0 and x greater than 1. And we got two problems. P1 has an optimal solution at 0,3, which is integer, so there's no need to explore further. Whereas P2, the optimal solution is 1,4 over 3. And since y is still fractional, we apply the same idea again. We use that value to guide us into dividing P2 into two subproblems. And both subproblems turn out to have integer optimal solutions. And so we could stop. So that's it for this introductory video on branching. We'll explore this topic a bit further in future videos.